this video is about a UDP program example, and it will illustrate presenting a sequence of UDP messages. Typical example would be live video, but it could really be any sequence of message where the data is not stored on any permanent storage. So it's generated and then either sent or lost, and then UDP is the best thing, because we favor in that case speed over quality. If data is lost, it's lost, and the consequence of that is decrease in quality. Okay, so this example is here in UDP stream reader and sender. So let's first have a look at the sending side. It takes one command line parameter, which is the IP address of the destination, saved here. Okay, and then we create an object of the UDP stream reader and call the sendStream method, and that's where the program stays forever, sending data. So the sendStream method sends data to the specified destination. We could have used multicast if the idea had been that anyone could have connected to this sender and received the stream. But in this example I'm using unicast. And the reason is that multicast is turned off on many networks, including Etherroam, so it tends to be problematic. We have to decide on the protocol, and the protocol here is extremely simple. The thing being transmitted is simply integers, and the protocol is just a sequence of integers. First message that is sent is 0, then 1, then 2, then 3, and so on, and that's it. This is really kind of cheating. There is no information about the content of the messages, and there is no length header specifying how long a message is. So the receiver will just read whatever it gets and just display it on the output. This would not have been appropriate if the data had been something that should be handled some way. For example, a video stream would have needed some information about the content. Maybe length header specifying how much data each packet was supposed to contain, so the receiver would have known that it had received everything. Okay, but this is just a trivial example to illustrate the UDP sending and receiving. So first we create the socket. It's not connected to anything. UDP is connectionless. Then we enter this loop and stay forever in the loop here, sending messages. So the integer that is sent is contained in this variable data to send, which is incremented after the message is sent. So first transform the integer into a byte buffer in this method here that is down there. Now we have the socket, and we also have the data to send in this buffer. So then we create a datagram packet. So the datagram packet was like the envelope that was posted to the postal service in the postal service analogy. So it's the thing that is being sent over the network. Create the datagram packet, and it contains the data here in the out buffer. Specify how big part of the buffer we want to send. We want to send it all, so therefore just out buffer dot length, and then the destination. So this is like writing the address on the envelope. To where do we want to send it? We want it to send it to destination that was specified on the command line. This thing here that came from main, and to this hard-coded port number that is defined here. Okay, so now we have the datagram packet, and it's time to send. We send it using the datagram socket that was stored in toStream. So toStream is used there to send the data, which is the datagram packet specified there. And then it's sent, so that's all. Then we sleep 1 millisecond here. Millisec is defined there in order not to choke the network completely or the receiver. So there's 1 millisecond interval between each data being sent. Then let's have a look at the receiving side, which is in UDP stream reader. So this program simply reads data from the UDP stream and shows it on the screen. So remember, the data was only integer values. So we have two threads here. One network thread that reads from the socket. So let's say this is the socket. So then we have a thread that reads data from the socket, places it in a queue. This is the queue, and then goes back again to read more data from the socket. So data arrives to the socket, of course, over the network from the sender. Then we have the other thread, which picks data from the queue, displays it on the screen, and then goes back to pick the next data from the queue, and so on. Note that it must be multi-threaded. We could not have the same thread doing both I/O, reading from the socket, and handling the UI, showing data on the screen. Or if the data would have been sent to a file, we still would have needed two threads, one for receiving it from the socket and one for storing it to the file. So we should not do both network handling and I/O or user interface on the same thread. Okay, so this is the architecture of this simple program. The main method down here just creates an object and calls the start method. So the start method starts the two threads, the network handling thread and the user interface thread. So the screen object, which is of type screenWriter, defined here, is the user interface thread, which is started. And this is the network thread, this object, which is also started. This object should handle the networking. And to be able to create a thread, it implements runnable. The runnable defines the run method of the thread, which is here. So here again, create the socket, which is not connected. There is no connection in UDP, but it's bound to a particular port number, namely this port number, which is of course the same as in the sending side. So we have the socket. Then we create a byte buffer to contain the data that will be received. And the size of the byte buffer is the size of an integer, since each message is just one integer. So we declare the packet that will contain the received data. It contains this buffer. And we intend to fill it. So then we call the socket from sender and do receive. To receive the datagram packet and fill this datagram packet with data. Then we loop over the entire length, that is the amount of bytes received, and byte by byte convert the received byte to an unsigned hex string in this method down here. Okay, that's just to have nice formatting when it's printed on the screen. But then we pass it to the print method in the screen. Let's have a look at that one. So the print method handles a length blocking queue. This is the queue values to handle declared up there. The length blocking queue has the methods put for inserting data and take, which is called down here when printing to the screen, to extract data. And put will block if the queue is full and it is not possible to add more data to the queue. Then this thread will be stuck in put until it is possible to add data. And corresponding for take takes the first inserted element from the queue, but if the queue is empty, it blocks until there is some data to take. So in the print method, remember that this one was called from the receiving thread, so the other thread here enters the print method and tries to do put. And if there's still room in the buffer, data is inserted. Then this thread returns and is ready to receive the next data from the socket. That was the receiving thread. Then we have the I/O thread, or maybe should be called the UI thread, that prints data on the screen, which is running here. It continuously calls take to get data from the buffer and blocks there until the other thread has inserted data in put and is then ready to receive next message. Okay, so this thread, the UI thread, loops here, and for each turn in the loop extracts a value from the queue and prints that value to the screen. So that's all in this program. Let's run it. Receiver is running. Start the sender. Sender is sending and receiver is receiving and prints the bytes in hex format.